Right, we're speaking about digestion and how does it work and why does it work? I think we've got to start at the beginning. Why do we have a digestive tract? That's the first question we have to ask. And the main reason is because your body cannot take an apple or a carrot or whatever else you're eating. It can't use it in that form. You've got to actually break it down. And so the digestive tract enables you to break down foods mechanically through chewing and chemically through digestive enzymes. So there's this sort of double prong or two-headed approach to digestion. It's mechanical, and we must always remember that mechanical part, because a lot of the digestive problems people have today is because they simply don't chew enough. Some people don't even chew their food. They just swallow it almost whole. Your digestive tract has teeth in your mouth specifically because you are supposed to chew, because at that point you will release enzymes to help you digest and break down starches, for example. So let's start with something like starches while we're talking about that. Starches are things what we call in carbohydrates as well, foods like potatoes and rice and pasta and bread and millet and most of the grains. And when we eat a potato, and I'm illustrating the potato because it's a simple enough food for all of us to know what it is and what it looks like rather than mentioning some exotic grain. When you eat a potato, you can't use it, you can't absorb it in that form, your body has to break it down. So you have to chew it very well. Your mouth secretes an enzyme called the ptyalin, spelled with a P just to confuse us, P-T-Y-L-I-N. It's also known as a salivary amylase. And that enzyme specifically is designed, what it does is it actually starts the process of breaking the molecules of carbohydrates apart. Think of it this way. It's like a long chain of beads or a string of pearls. And each of those beads or pearls on the string is one molecule of glucose. So carbohydrates come into our body in long chains of glucose molecules. And we can't use it like that. We've got to break it apart into individual molecules of glucose. So the first stage of digestion takes place in your mouth, breaking it from that long chain into what we call a double chain. Well, its correct name then is a disaccharide. So this long chain is a polysaccharide. Poly mean many, saccharide meaning glucose. And your body now breaks that down to disaccharides in the mouth. That's where the digestive process takes place. And that is now the disaccharide, di meaning two. Now, that takes place in your mouth and continues in your stomach. And then the final stage of starch digestion is in your small intestine, where you secrete more intestinal amylases, which now breaks it down from a double molecule of glucose. So you've got this double molecule, breaks it apart so that you've got two individual molecules of glucose. And at that point, it can get into the bloodstream and be absorbed and used by the body. And we need glucose for your brain and central nervous system to work properly. And if you're not supplying your body with enough of the right kind of natural glucose that you find in whole foods, then you could find yourself being irritable. You could find yourself suffering from mental issues, depression, mood swings, irrational thoughts, anxiety. There are a whole lot of things that can go wrong with the body when we're not getting enough carbohydrates. So getting it in a whole food form means we're able to use it optimally. Okay, so that's the process of digestion with starches.